pretty good at sense now. I'm passable at sense.
Okay. As the game goes on, I'll probably provide some more information since you don't know the map.
I don't know Black Ops, mainly.
Okay, copy that. You can go T2 on one of your comms straight away. You should have enough power if you don't build too many mixes. Your Seraphim Black Ops ACU has got 365 plus power if you go for the T2 economy upgrade.
I suppose that depends on the faction, because mine just has 230.
Yeah, you're probably UEF or Cyber.
Yeah.
The Aeon provides something similar to the Sera. About minute 25 drone, there's going to be enemy SACUs not teleporting into your base but scripted to spawn, so you can't stop them with anti-teleport, but you can kill them with whatever PD you want.
Yep.
But they have anti-teleport?
The anti-teleport unit PD does work, but these SACUs are not
they
not
don't actually teleport, they're just like cheat teleported.
Yeah,
no, I'm just surprised there is an anti-teleport unit.
Yeah, there is. I think it's a Black Ops thing, I think, maybe.
Yeah, or, well, it's definitely not a usual thing.
So yeah, by minute 20 or so, you'll need to have at least one of your ACUs in your mix field. Yeah, they spawn around your mix fields. So. Also, the Aeon faction has got a T3 anti-air turret that's got the best anti-air. Everyone will need that turret. A few of them are around their base. So, Nod PC, we need to. So what do you think you'll do for Navy Drove, since I've told you those?
All T2 ACUs on this build, Destros.
Destroyers, did you say?
Yeah.
Okay. Surface ships will attract a lot of fire. There's going to be Tempests coming in minute 25 or so.
Could make cruisers then, and Destros. I'll start with Destros. What comes originally? What comes down?
There's gonna be it's obviously it's all gonna scale up. So but there's gonna be some
hover.
There's gonna be some surface ships that have got like 12k HP. So killing them with destroyers, they're gonna take a lot of damage before you can kill them.
So none of them have good torps then.
Say again. None of them have what?
You have good torps. They have good torpedoes. Only one of my ACs is Black Ops.
Correct. Also, Drode, there is every faction has got a T1 anti-naval PV. It's excellent. It's got long range and good damage.
Okay.
They can go on water as well.
The pill time of that is insane though, 8 minutes. That's 6 minutes.
Under attack. Commander under attack.
Minute 15, Drove, where your ACU is right now, right near the shore, there's going to be land units. I can't do much about killing them, so you'll have to have your ACU there or have some PD there. One more thing, the Black Ops ACU overcharge is bugged. Good eco. Okay. Hey guys, enemy bombers incoming soon. Drow, can you hear me?
Wow, he's at Saxo, presumably he's not here.
He's at what? Saxo?
No, he said 1 second.
Oh, yes, yes, he did say that. Just wondering, because I need to tell him that there's enemy bombers coming and he could lose half his mexes if he doesn't prepare. That would hurt. He's got 3 T3 mexes soon.
What the hell? When I double-click my Turk MK2 PDs, only some of them are selected, like there are 2 unit types.
Yeah, I think that's what you're asking. Yeah, for some reason there's a MK1 and a MK2 thug PD. One of them has got 2 barrels and the other one has got a single barrel.
Oh yeah, I have MK1. What the fuck?
Yeah, MK2 is still a T1 PD, but it's got 2 barrels, so it's actually got twice the DPS for the same price.
What?
Yeah, when your ACU is upgraded to D2, then you can build it. I think regular T1 NGs might be able to build it, I'm not sure. Also, a lot of your PDs are targeting the Navy, I think, maybe.
Oh yeah, indeed, MK1 is the one. Well, they're both at the tier 1 level, but if you have a tier 1 NG, you get the MK1.
Yep.
What? Yeah, I know about the Navy. I'm also going to walk my ASU over to overcharge some of it, but then I run out of power.
Copy that. The Serra anti-naval PD is the best at killing these units that come towards your base, you know, these ships, because they have just the right damage and just the right fire rates for 2 of them to kill one of these frigates in one pass.
Is this a thing you built on water or on land?
Are you talking about my PD?
Yeah, the anti-navy PD you were talking about.
Yeah. So every faction has got the anti-navy PD, and I was saying the Serra one seems to be the best.
Okay, I have one. It looks like you can put it both on land and on water.
Yes, you can put the anti-navy on land, but if you place it close to where your other PDs are, it's going to hit the... When it fires, it's not going to hit the frigates, it's going to hit the land.
Okay.
The land's going to block. The best thing, if you really want to get rid of them, is just T1 artillery.
Mm-hmm.
Because, as you know, the arty shells will fly over the land and then make sure to hit.
Are you talking about normal tier 1 artillery, or is there like an experimental tier 1 artillery building?
No, just regular vanilla T1 artillery. Blayhamster, the mini boss is coming to the left. What is Drow doing? Drow, we were discussing a few things. One of the things is there's going to be enemy bombers coming in soon. You need to shield your base and make some SAMs, or you could lose a lot of your mixes. Bro, did you copy that?
Yeah.
Commander under attack.
Yes, maybe.
The best place to build your factories is to the left of me. If you build it to the north of where you are, the long range units are gonna pound your stuff.
Here is the game kind of laggy.
Seems fine to me.
Do you have a cyber and teaser engine, please?
Go.
Yeah, copy. I've got a. Well, I'm gonna have T3. I'm building T3, but I'll give you two now. Dinged. Did you receive an A on NG, bro?
Hey, no.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Did you get one?
I got one. Yeah.
Okay, I've just given you mine. I'm going straight to T3 with my Aeon factory. Enemy bombers. 17th, there's these T1 Navy units that have got 12k HP. You're gonna need T3 units to deal with stuff like that.
They have an AMT branded.
Copy that. Cave 2. Pinged.
Do we need Annies in that?
Say again, do we need
Annies? Anti-nukes.
Oh, anti-nukes, yes, but towards the end of the game there's gonna be T3 nuke subs which will randomly target pieces of your base, so two or three missiles will be just fine. Okay guys, I'm sending T3 engineers to the middle. Cybron ones. Okay, I need to start a Yolana, please, Dro. Can you give me a T3 NG?
Yep. Oh my god.
Oh no! Painful.
So funny. Every one of these looks.
When did the support issues come?
They should be transporting. Yeah, I've already had one, so I've got a PC. They're going to be random,
oh.
So they've already started to come.
points.
Oh wow. Yeah, minute 25, you've got a wave of that. Yeah.
What's the name of the good air?
Sky Tracker.
Okay, that was called Sky. Do you know? Did they change it?
Sky Tracker.
Yeah, I have it. But I'm remembering that it was called Sky Cleaner, if you remember.
I think the Sky Cleaner is the T2 UEF, isn't it, or something? Bro, you just don't have space to assist with the T1 engineers.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Are you floating mass right now?
15 back.
I'm struggling to get these arms up.
I'll build shield actually.
Still assisting, you know, that's rebuilt of this. You know. I also managed to build 3 Percys at the same time, which is great efficiency wise.
Okay, Yolanda is at 32%.
To best take out long range shit like the RT.
I'm sorry, can you repeat please?
How to best take out the long range land units like the RT?
You can build TMLs or. Yeah.
A monkey. Oh my god, that explodes!
Yes, there's lots of different units that do lots of different things, which is why knowing the map is a good idea. All of the mods. Are inbound and they've got drones as well. Nowhere near prepared enough.
What? Restoration fields? What? That's epic. Does this affect buildings?
Yes, it does. The T2 restoration field does. Anyone got a nuke or anything, or artifacts to deal with this tempest?
I have tech, but they're not adventure.
Salvation. Why did those monkeys not get masks?
That bug is being worked on. They don't leave behind wrecks on land, but they leave half their mass in water. HP boss coming towards you, Entropy.
Mm-hmm. I have two of these guy thingies written on the back side though.
from here it looks like Kartan and Layham Sura competing with each other to see who can build the best defenses. But really we need endgame things like Artemis and Villana.
No way you can stop those cruisers anyway, though.
There's no way we can do what to the cruisers?
Stop the cruisers.
What, the ones next to the Tempest?
Yeah, that and you as well.
If I was able to build one Scathist, then those Tempests would have been gone. Along with the cruisers, of course. But I'm just using all my mass on holding my shield and building the Yolanda. Usually by this time we have like 50 Wrath Sakus reclaiming everything. Sorry, not Wrath ACUs, just regular SACUs reclaiming all the stuff from the water. But it's just not gone according to plan here. Well, at least my Yolanda's defensive resist. 80% struggling for mass.
Found my attacks ran out. And no moss. Just building SMB.
Beetlebots incoming now. One short range, one long range on the left. Got one long range on the right. Kartan, if we play together again with Layhamster can usually take care of mid by himself, so you really don't need to invest that much in front defenses until later on. Aeon, then you can build more eco. What do you think of the map so far, Dro?
It's pretty good. I'd like to build RAS ACs, so they could be like harder.
Yeah, you can build RAS AC, but they're very... you can't, sorry, I'm struggling for words. They're not preset.
Oh.
Yeah, so you build a regular one or engineer SAC.
That's so weird.
And also, most of the RAS has been nerfed as well. So you're, instead of 11 mass, but you get 8 or something.
Elon
yeah.
is getting 11 at least.
Yeah, I'm trying to load my Yolanda, but I don't have.
The EF is
if you could send me some mass, please, so I can load that Yolanda.
No, I'll come after right when he's checking, brother.
Seconds, and I'm stalling again.
We have a big pile of useless and catalysts.
Has anyone got any SMD missile loaded? I see lots of SMD launcher.
I have one almost loaded.
It's a mistake, I made one of my. So you got 4 and 1. One of my last
Wait,
games. Yeah, like
that is
10.
Right? Yeah, okay.
Losing all my stuff on the front now. My shield's failed.
How can we help?
Beggars shoot me from under the water. Please fix.
Okay, next Yolanda going to the beach box. Oh, we've got an Artemis there. Okay. I'll try and target some of the T2R. Yeah, I've got that last beetle bot cut out. killing a snake bite with ground fire.
Almost done.
Yeah, copy that.
But this is dangerous because my silos are stalled. So if somebody has spare moss, I'm gonna really use it for SMD.
Strategic launch detected. Strategic launch detected.
You're maybe wasting a bunch of mass by assisting shield in the center.
Copy that.
Strategic launch detected.
So far, I think I've got all the nukes with one silo that's happily assisted.
Oh, I see that one.
Fighter is finally out. Generators would be there, I would have put the super shield more to the front.
Percy's are slightly better.
Wait, do the Lambdas actually do damage?
Yeah, they do 4k damage every 6 or 7 seconds.
With projectile or what? Oh yeah.
Yeah, with the projectile, yeah. 4.4k every 6.67 seconds and long range as well. But the best thing about them is they're really fast recharge on their personal shield. I've never actually seen that bird work, but I have seen it work on the ACU, the Lambda Field. Dreadnoughts incoming. Have you seen these dreadnoughts before, Crow?
No.
See the spawn point? These are beasts. They got projectiles that do 7k damage. And they got three of them.
Fucking hell. I don't have any
Oh yeah, me too. I completely forgot about that. I've got one AMG.
Oh, at least oh, it survived.
This is the build bar, isn't it?
Yeah.
There were two of those.
Heal the quick.
Wait, the game ends at 50 minutes, right?
52 is when the final boss spawns.
Okay, it's still going.
Oh shit, the bigger power generators need more power, the underwater ones.
Yeah, they blow up. Land. Yep.
Which one are better though? Are they both the same efficiency?
I'm not sure.
What's that?
You can get almost 9k power from a single P-gen if you surround it with storage. So I think what it comes down to more than anything, where you place them and how well you shield them. Strategic launch How much HP do you think the final boss had, bro? Can you take a wild guess?
420,000.
Not even close. Times that by 10 and you get it. we are both about to be annihilated. You've got Dreadnoughts coming up, Serra Dreadnought.
They have more range than the Serra TP, do they?
Yeah. Most Dreadnoughts have.
They have more range than they are.
Huh?
Do they have more range than the T3 Arctic?
No. I have one scan this. That's it.
No, I mean like the heavy plasma artillery does have more range than that.
What, like the emissary?
Oh, the T3, like, two, T. I don't know how to describe it. It's like T2 Arty, that's T3. It's not getting insane range. It's got like Arty range. T2 Arty range.
What? 150 range? Like a Summit? Or 180? Summit is 150. I think some of these dreads have got 180 range.
I think it's fine then, yeah. Take it home.
Bro, you weren't kidding, you want lag. Why is that? What are you playing on?
Laptop? I haven't seen it, okay. Yeah. So not lagging that bad though.
No, you're not. I think the bottleneck right now is not PCs. But how come you score 230 something?
I don't know. It isn't overclocked that much.
Actually surprised my box can run the game fastest. This one. Since I have AMD.
Oh my god, how many drones do you have?
Me?
Yeah, 100?
42. Yeah, most of my things are still uploading after they got killed.
I'm surviving just by reclaiming
I'm just watching it unfold. I don't know what I'm gonna do for the rest of this game. I played so bad. I had no idea like what the fuck was going on. That experimental mag is just terrible. Do enough damage.
GG. Blaze of glory. There you go. Yeah, not PCs minus 7.
Overflow 20k power for everyone.
Wow, thanks for giving Boss a minus 170k now.
What power, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
So all your shields have gone.
Well, I'm not really having a shield at the front anyway, so.
Okay. final wave has spawned, so everything that's on the map now is all that there is left to kill.
So the Philander generator prevent the Zarek from doing damage.
So what was the first part?
Does the Lambda field generator prevent the Zarek from doing damage?
Lambda field generator?
Yeah, the Seraphim one. The experimental one.
What, the point defense?
Yeah.
Well, Layhamster is saying, yeah, it's shields, but it did damage. He's saying no. Kartan probably has about 1k mass. Is that right?
What the fuck? Mass and energy storage.
Oh, 1185. That's disappointing.
Where do we have the extra control?
Rest seconds. Bloody Yolanda doesn't shoot a lot. Okay, who has got positive income? I'm gonna give you the Yolanda and my engineers can't load it anymore.
Yeah,
I can't get to the reclaim. Anyone got positive income?
Or I'll give you all my income.
Okay, last you'll on the firing.
Don't overflow.
Yeah, I'd want to give it to a couple of the mid players. One of the mid players who's got positive income.
I'll give you mass.
No, I don't have the power to do that either with my shields. Give it to Kartan.
So he does this mass and energy storage give more bonus?
It doesn't do it for mass extractors and mass rapidians. Probably not.
Okay, so all I can do now is try and hold my shields and not let the dreadnoughts get too close to you guys. I can't do anything else now. Yep,
and
that's fine.
My silos are...
No, Kartan, sorry, Kartan, no, don't fire at Navy. Those dreadnoughts have got two SMDs each. Now all that's remaining, if mid will probably hold, definitely they've got enough PD, is to do damage to the Omega, depending on which one we get. The anti-boss turret needs to be upgraded at some point as well.
What's the range on the dreadnought SMDs?
Regular, I believe. I've got one SMD loaded in my base. And,
how can you upgrade the thing?
How can it what?
Oh, it's owned by Blamster.
One, two, three, four. I've got four experimental shields that I'm trying to hold. city in both corners between our bases, just so you know. As long as most of the mid-PD survives, there should be enough damage for the Omega boss, which can have between 5 million HP and 8 million HP. With a ton of regen, of course. As we kill more of the units, of course, it'll get. Just wait for the speed increase. Lehamster, what do you need to upgrade your anti-boss turret? I see it as halfway done almost.
To me to help the red.
Okay, got mini boss coming down the center right. Probably best to target that once the upgrade is complete. Once it's got 60k HP, then it's complete.
Rats?
Sorry? Rats?
No, rats. Might go through there. If you have 300 HP.
trying to scout to see which Omega it is, because we might need a lot of anti-air. There's another three. Oh, it's the anti-air boss.
The anti-air boss?
Alright, you've got four more Scathis on the right. Cartan. Right, so anti-air boss, it's gonna have. It's got. It's a little bit bugged. It needs to be. Debugged.
Air boss? Or
wait, how are you building. How are you building the team of scouts?
I've got a factory. Okay. Blayhamster, it's coming towards your base. When it lands, it will regen all its HP, and then you can hit it with land. And Cartan, you might need some anti-air there as well. Yeah, it's coming between Cartan and his base.
Is it this Omega thing?
Yeah.
Oh, it's already almost dead.
It's right here. Yeah, it should have its full 4 million HP. I don't know why it's.
Okay. It's coming to the crack place. Strategic launch detected. Should I have all my hair?
Two fortresses on the front, which are almost dead. Ready?
Commander under attack.
How did you build the air factory?
Strategic launch detected.
Nervous.
Yes.
How did you build the air factory?
How?
Yeah.
What do you mean, how did I build the air factory? Anyone can build the air factory.
Oh yeah. What the hell? I thought air was disabled somehow. Is it disabled at the beginning of the game or something like that?
No, not at all.
Huh.
Okay, 40k HP left on Beetlebot.
I got 50 sky trackers.
Alright, good, it's actually heading towards the sky tracker. When it lands, it should regen all its HP. On a nuke 5 seconds. Oh, all its minions have spawned, and it's got 3 million HP. It should have. Alright, good job, guys. That should be it. It's not firing anything?
Difficulty to tell with all the projectiles. Can it move it? It looks like it's firing missiles. Oh yeah, it's definitely still doing damage.
Oh yeah, it's firing TMLs.
Yeah, but they're not normal TMLs. Can it still move like this?
No. No, it can't walk.
Can it be hit by AA? No?
No. So I believe the idea was to have a Air Omega that when it's killed it becomes like a stationary target. So that was 4 million missing HP.
What if you like draw it? What if it like kills everything but isn't in range of the objective?
Ah, Nervous managed to hold. Damn those missiles. Why do you build Zapper and not it's called Purgers. The Aeon Tier 3 Tag Defense.
Sorry, is that for me?
Yeah.
Why do I... what?
So you have lots of tags coming at your base, and you just have a few zappers and some shields. Why not build the Purgers? Are they not good?
The Purgers do work. I think Blayhamster knows more about it. But the purifier, the T3 TML, doesn't work. So I don't know. I'm just used to building T2 TMD.
Aeon T2 TMD is the best anyway.
Yeah, but with the radius of the shields, you have to build them right up at the front for them to, you know, because they, even though they get deflected, they still impact the shields. Yeah. Okay, GG guys, thanks for playing.
Yeah, GG.
That was lucky that we got this Omega. If it was another Omega that does stun or something, it would have wrecked the front.
Why?
Because the stun has got long range and a good recharge as well.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, it stuns all the PD. Anyway.
Yeah. GG, I'm off for today. Thanks for playing.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.